What's up, Independence?
Welcome to the news.
Soy el fuego que arde tu piel. Soy el agua que mata tu sed. El castillo, la torre, yo soy. La espada que guarda el guardal. Tú el aire que respiro yo. Y la luz del año en el mar. La garganta que se moja. Que tema hogar y amor. Iguales deseos me vas a dar. Oh, dices tú, mi tesoro basta con mirar. Oh, y tuyo será.
Habitat for Humanity will be selling t-shirts for $15. If you are interested, please see Mr. Londot in room A206. Yearbooks will be on sale until today. After today, there will be a limited quantity that will be sold on a first-come, first-served basis.
Softball tryouts will be held on Monday, February 12th and Tuesday, February 13th, right after school. You must have an up-to-date physical present on the first day of tryouts. If you have any further questions, please see Coach Brown or Coach Buchanan.
Tennis team tryouts will be taking place on February 12th at 3:15 on the courts. You must have an up-to-date physical to participate. See Coach Balzer in room F185 with any questions.
And now for sports with Brooks and Jalen.
What's up, Indy Nation? I'm Brooks Howard.
And I'm Jalen Chesson.
And this is your Indy Sports.
Swimming has state this next weekend. Congratulations to the girls, Colleen, Megan, and Maddie.
And for the guys, Harrison, Evan, Andre, and Michael.
Frisbees also started off their season, girls winning 1-2 games, boys winning both.
Independence had 5 athletes sign this past Wednesday on National Signing Day. Let's go get into the action.
I'm here with Kyle. So, where are you going?
UAB.
What are you looking forward to?
Being a true freshman there, being able to kick all 4 years, and living in Birmingham would be fun.
Selena, where are you going?
University of the Cumberlands.
Cool. What are you looking forward to?
Meeting new teammates and just meeting new people, exploring. Because where I'm going, I don't know anyone there, so it would be really cool to just meet new people and new teammates.
I'm here with Gentry now. Gentry, where are you going to college?
Belmont.
What are you looking forward to at Belmont?
Playing lots of soccer.
Kate, where are you going?
I'm going to Gardner-Webb University.
What are you excited about most?
I'm excited about the student life and, of course, soccer. But everybody's, like, super inclusive at Gardner-Webb, so
I'm excited. Peyton, where are you going to college?
I'm going to Austin Peay State University.
Why'd you choose them?
I chose it because they offered me good money, and I really like it there.
What's one thing that you're looking forward to?
Playing soccer.
In case you missed last night's game, let's go check out the seniors that were honored.
If you are what you say you are, a superstar, then have no fear. The camera's here and the microphones, and they wanna know. Oh, 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 yeah. If you are what you say you are, a superstar, then have.
That's a wrap for this week of Urani Sports.
Have a fantastic, fun-filled weekend.
Today is the last day that FCCLA will be selling flowergrams during lunches. Stop by the table to send your friend, crush, or love a rose on Valentine's Day for just $2. The money will go towards supporting your local community service programs. Girls and boys track tryouts will begin Monday, February 12th at 3:10 on the track. You must have an up-to-date physical present in order to participate.
Baseball tryouts will be February 12th, right after school at the baseball field. You must have an up-to-date physical in order to participate. For more information, see Coach McLowry. February 13th will be our readout. We will be getting ready to kick off Heart Health Month. Vital sign screenings will be done in front of the gym during the JV basketball games.
Mr. Taylor's science class recently had some fun with some dry ice. Let's find out more.
My name is Mr. Taylor and I teach physical science. Today we did one of my favorite demos to do. I usually try to do it every year, which is fun with dry ice. I think they liked it, seemed to be pretty excited. You can always see sort of the look on their faces and see people sort of getting interested in stuff. Maybe they haven't got to see that in person before. The chapter that we're studying is about states of matter, temperatures, specifically phase changes, states going from solids to liquids, liquids to gases. And so dry ice is a real world example of how a substance actually skips the liquid state and goes straight from a solid to a gas, which we call sublimation. So because that happens, we can get some really cool effects, such as a lot of fog. It condenses the water vapor, gives us a cool effect, and then you can use that to do various other things with it. So.
Coffee and ice cream will now be served in the Commons on Fridays. Here's more.
What's up, guys? I'm back here at Indie Nation. I hope your Christmas break was good, because mine was, for sure. But I got something to tell you. We got a deal steal for you. It's coffee and ice cream on Fridays. It's only $2. Get it at all lunches. It's pretty great, but I got to show you. Roll it.
WCS Raise Your Hands program needs high school volunteers to work with teachers and first through fourth grade students to increase students' reading and math skills. The next session begins on February 12th. They typically ask for 1 hour of service per week from 3:30 to 4:50 p.m. Interested students should see Ms. Monforti in the Counseling Center for an application.
The French Club will be having their next meeting Monday, February 12th from 3 to 4 in Madam Carson's classroom to celebrate Mardi Gras. Also, French Club will be ordering t-shirts. Short sleeves are $20 and long sleeves are $25. Please see Madam Carson during sixth period or after school to order your t-shirt.
Today is Jamba Juice Friday for HOSA. Jamba Juice will be selling smoothies for $4 in the Commons. The Gay Straight Alliance will meet next Wednesday, February 4th at 7 a.m. in room D123. All are welcome to attend.
Mrs. Howard's art class is working on an interesting new project. Here's more on that.
So they're working on a linoleum block carving, and they get to choose their subject or their topic of what they want to work on for their image. The material is a piece of linoleum, and they're taking a linoleum cutter and carving into the image. It's really easy to carve, and it's kind of meant to be something that prepares them for sculpture. It's getting into a little bit of 3D, but it's still 2D, if that makes sense. And then they're going to make multiple prints off of their image. Good design, and something that they're interested in. Like, I want to see my students choose subject matter that they like and that would get them excited. Good craftsmanship, safety, because they are using some tools that, you know, are sharp. So making sure that they go through all the safety precautions, and then the printing process and coming out with an image that's nice, that's successful. This one can take a little bit because printmaking is a kind of a lengthy process, and there's lots of steps involved. So you have to have a little bit of patience. They'll probably spend probably about a week and a half working on it. Actually, we do this one every year. It's normally one of the favorite projects. Something about the act of like carving into material and the printing process. Usually students like that one, so I tend to do it every year. We get some really good results with it, so it's pretty successful. I keep it around. Surprisingly, I haven't had a lot of like accidental injuries with the tools. Everybody's really safe with the tools, and the images come out really well. So I would say overall that it's successful. They get good results with it.
Mr. Pickle recently got a new virtual reality headset. Let's take a gander.
Oh, hey, Independence. I recently had the opportunity to go check out Mr. Pickerel's VR headset.
Am I about to go outside?
Yes.
This is insane. Wait, I'm gonna write my real name, my God-given name.
Change
builders. Oh, really?
Well, this is architectural engineering design, and we recently purchased a virtual reality equipment. We're going to take the equipment and be able to take our students' designs and architecture and be able to walk through the student-created houses.
I got a pebble. There's a carrot.
Not a carrot.
I figured it out.
Mu Alpha Theta recently had their annual Perry Creek Math Night. Here's more on that.
So we are at Perry Creek Elementary with the Mu Alpha Theta organization, and we are helping Perry Creek put on their math night. So the math night is for their kindergarten through fifth graders, and just to remind them that math is fun, they have incentives, they earn money for playing math games, and they get to turn it in for prizes at the end. It is kind of a philanthropy math club, if you can put it that way. Our goal is to remind kids, students of all ages, that math is fun, and we want to continue to instill that so that when they're in high school, they still believe that math is fun and they want to come to our classes.
Well, Independence, that's all for this week.
And a reminder, Monday is a Power Monday.